Hey guys, we're going to Scape a Terra for you today, and I'll just walk you through all the steps that you need to follow. You know, there's so many different ways to Scape. This is just one of many ways, and this is the way that we kind of prefer it by a lot. So usually we'll start using decorative gravel, and we do a gravel perimeter around the entire tank. Kind of do this in phases. I'll do a bit of gravel just to kind of protect the edges from getting any other plant debris down. And then I'll go right into doing like a wall. So once you get kind of a base amount of gravel everywhere, then you can add the sphagnum moss to the living wall. So just take a bunch of this. Start stuffing it in the back. Yeah, right to the top. And they don't have to be like totally full. They're totally a preference. I'll usually like exactly what they're going to get to the perfect. Because once you add the moss on top of the plants, what I really want to do is every time you add a plant to there, you'll actually
that's marvelous. Look at the ease the Biopod offers.
Thank you. it's an aquatic aquarium setup, mm-hmm. you want to use sphagnum because it'll keep the water clear.
Right.
Unless you want, you know, a lot of tannins in the water, mm-hmm. which, you know, some people might want for
black water.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So that's an option. That's,
yeah, normally it's best to just use sphagnum. There's still tannins that come from. I think just generally the water stays crystal clear when you use this. And then this also serves as a really good substrate for, you know, beneficial bacteria to do all the filtration. So you get,
the benefits of an aquaponics system.
Yeah, exactly. You've got the plants
and also
so normally once you finish, you just find a good place for this. Generally just kind of center of the tank.
Mm-hmm.
And that'll just measure the soil temperature.
Right. Well, it depends on what kind of plants you're going to put in, right?
Yeah, exactly. And then this area in the front, some people want to have a little pool, a little water pool or whatever. So it's nice. This has no false bottom, so you can do whatever you want. So in this case, normally what I do is I'll use this here, and then just keep a thin layer of gravel in front of it, and then it just keeps it lined up so you don't have an awesome amount of gravel.
Should I move the excess on top?
The sphagnum?
Yeah.
No, that's fine. It can be. Yeah, it can go.
So you're saying, these are used for a particular reason. These ones?
Yeah, just to keep it light, and they don't get waterlogged. So rather than using all gravel there, unless you're doing like a little pool in the front, mm-hmm. then you might as well use gravel. But if not, for this, it just keeps
more.
Keep adding, and then once add the stones, kind of behind it. So that separates the soil as well, so it doesn't go into the water layer.
Mm-hmm.
And then,
well, that's the look in 9 minutes, 45 seconds.
Hey, nice. And then just add a little layer of sphagnum over top of this. So that's just going to be kind of an additional barrier for any soil.
Right. So is it okay to keep the sensor on top of the tray? Or?
Yeah, it's perfect. Yeah. Okay. So yeah, we want this kind of buried in the soil, mm-hmm. Just kind of at a little bit above that. But even if it's touching that, that's fine.
Should I add some more gravel, you said?
Yeah.
that's our fertilizer going to break?
Yeah, this has, it has no fertilizer in it, but it just has a mix of the bark and peat moss and perlite. Yeah.
The slope from the back.
Yeah. That should probably be good for now. We can save the rest for scaping, yeah.
Back in the soil now is a good idea, or?
I usually do it, yeah, just to kind of, so that there's less settling.
Mm-hmm. And then the system, you have oxygenation anyway.
Exactly, yeah.
So.
So I think it's totally, you know, your own preference how you do it.
This drift is from Malaysia?
This is, I believe it's actually from China.
Oh.
So this is, they call it spiderwood.
Yeah,
but
spiderwood.
It's azalea
yeah.
root.
Yeah. It looks awesome.
It's a lot of it is actually also available in the southern part of India.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That's the stuff they saved up.
Yeah, so there's some extra bark. And then now we can kind of go crazy with the plants. So let's see. Usually what I like to do is
start with a focal point or?
Well, like you know what, I don't have like a particular method.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the most important is to get the back wall scaped.
Right.
So what I like to do is play around with plants, get an arrangement, and then take them all out, and then scape the back wall, and then add everything afterwards where I kind of know that I want it to be. In doing that, starting with vermilia, it's that kind of want to put in there.
In the back wall?
Yeah, and this I'll probably put in the front, but I just want to see the arrangement first.
Okay.
Before we're
actually
committing to anything, yeah.
You hear the crickets.
Yeah. Yeah. And sometimes it just works out, so you don't have to limit anything. You can kind of call it around it.
Mm-hmm.
Especially on the smaller thing.
Want to add some color crickets?
Yeah, of course.
Favorite plant.
Nice. Yeah, that's good.
much do you keep with?
Yeah, exciting. It's the most fun part of it. Yes, putting it all together.
Yeah. So if it wants to stay, you know, I don't rip it.
You open them as often
sometimes.
Yeah, during the time lapse, those are always really cool.
Also, whatever presidency comes off
is
what comes off.
I really wanted to do one set up. We haven't had the chance to set up a camera dedicated to just the thing. Set it up.
Yeah.
About somebody else?
Yeah.
And then
I was watching
the Scape is starting up with a bloom in your face. Excuse me. A bloom in your face. Like
Totally.
Thank you. put them in? Sometimes you do this first, sometimes, you know, after.
Possibly easier doing it first.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
So when you cut these in, you put this in the magnet?
Yeah, and then you put it near the top.
Before you use
different
muscles as well?
Yeah.
Combination?
Yeah. So just depending on what's available.
I see in the
Our moss selection.
Mm-hmm.
Mostly is between two different types. But this is actually the most used here.
Contours, like right there, you have a straight line. So
yeah. you usually break that down with sticking out.
Yeah, so I always like to add Talancias at the end.
Okay.
And it does a great job of just totally, you know, kind of distracting from that.
That's gonna add some contrast too. Sticking out some of the old leaves. Here, what do you think? If you put this guy behind those.
Totally good.
That looks good.
Yeah, that's that one plant, rare South American one. Really stand out.
It's like a fancy meeting to.
Yeah. So you can use like the glue.
Mm-hmm.
It's always nice.
You don't use dye, is it?
It looks
fun.
Yeah, I sometimes do, sometimes don't. It totally depends. Whether I can get them to stay in or not.
usually ties in best.
This is the lazy man's way with the Palancius. It's like,
there you go.
That's easy.
Yeah.
Another picture.
Yeah. Is it maybe enough for the radio? Is this another one? Maybe not there. Just have it. Yeah.
Come on, I've got some more chips and plugins in.
Yeah, okay.
That's a success in 39 minutes, 14 seconds.
I like what this does, but it also kind of overwhelms.
It's nice. I mean, it's just that it gives more depth.
Yeah. Totally.
You think right at that, and then you still want to go that far, or?
Maybe, yeah. Let's try it. Let's see.
looks nice.
Yeah. Good job.
And
all right.
Dad.
So we shut the doors finally. We create a new scape of biodiversity. Awesome, guys. Thank you.